Hey, welcome to another edition of Subject Smart. So today we'll be talking about functions. Now, talking about functions, what gets come to our head? Now, functions are very, very easy. Now, in further mathematics, you cannot run away from things like functions. Now, functions are simply what? Redefining of what? Expression. That is, assigning duty from one particular variable to another variable. Now, the duties, the numbers or variables you are assigning, they can either be real numbers or they can be what? Addition or subtraction of what? Multiple what? Variables. Now, what am I trying to say here? First and foremost, I would like to explain some notations or terms which we use when it comes to complex numbers, when it comes to functions. Now, look at this. Looking at them. Now, if I have this as A and I have this as B, now, I have my elements here, A, B, C, and I have my elements here, 1, 2, 3. Now, first and foremost, this particular set here, it's called your set A, and this set A, its elements here are A, B, and C. Now, this particular set here is known as the domain, of the function. Now, your B, your set B here, which is equal to 1, 2, 3, this is known as the codomain. This is known as the what? Your codomain. Now, it is a function connected to this by what? F. Now, I'll let us pay close attention. Now, if A is what? A has an image here. Okay, B has an image, and C here has its own image. Now, first and foremost, I would like us to go going through this particular term. So, what is what image? Now, your image is when it has what a corresponding element in A. So, now, still talking about your image. Your image is a function that has it, a corresponding word, element in your A. Now, when this is directed, when your elements here are directed to this part, now it's what they are directed to at this end is what? Its image. Please, I'd like us not to take it for the range. Now, the range of the function. The range of the function. Now, this range, this the range and the image are always very, very what? Intriguing. When I say intriguing, their students get to mistake them. Now, for example, now let's say in this particular function, I don't have my 3. I don't have my what? C connected to my 3. Let's say it's connected to my the 2 here. Now, what will be the image of this particular what? Function. Now the image of this function here is going to be what? 1 and 2. Now why is it 1 and 2? The image has to do with what? The particular connections in this part, in this what? Your codomain. So if I have a function, a very quick one, if I have a function 1, 2, 3, 4, and I have another function here, A, B, C, D. If I have this as my let's say I have this as my M and have this as my M, then I connected by what function M. If I set this to this, this connected to this, this connected to this, and this connected to this. If all these are connected to this, now if you are asked for the range of this particular function, the range of this particular function here, range of this particular function here is what? A. Now, don't need for paying close attention. Now, your function has to do with what? The corresponding what? Element of your domain. But now, if you are asked for the image is what? The element in your code domain. So, if I ask you for the image, your image here is your element in the code domain. And what are the elements in code domain? A, B, C, and D. If you are asked for the if you are asked for the domain, so your domain here is what the element in M, and what are the elements in M? The element in M there is a 1, 2, 3, and 4. So with this, I believe we are getting a particular what? I believe we are getting understanding. Now, so you reviewing this here. Now I have what my arrow diagram. This illustration here is known or called the arrow diagram. So this particular expression here is called what? Your arrow diagram. So look at here, they said here that your f of one here is x. Your f of one is x, your f of two is y, your f of 3 is also y, your f of 4 here is a. Now, so therefore, x here is an image of 1. Y here is an image of 2 and 3, and a here is an image of 4. Now, if I ask you for the element of the, if I ask you for the codomain, your codomain here is, sorry, your domain. Your domain here, your domain here is your set M. And set M has its elements as 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, if I ask for the codomain, your codomain is what? Set. Your set what? M, which is your codomain. Now, going further, if I ask for the image here is what? The element of the codomain, which is x, y. So that will x, y, pay close attention, z, and a. But then if I ask for the range, so the range of your function here, are what? The particular element that is corresponded to what is set in M. So what are those ones that are corresponded then, which is your what? Your X, your Y, and your A. So this particular expression here is known as what? The range of the function. So, having understood this, let's go further to understand what a relation is. So, we're going to be talking about relation. Now, the relation is also the kind of function. Now, so going further here, I have this. Now, talking about relation, I said, before we go into relation proper, I'd like to tell us what the properties of a relation. Now, the first important property is that every element of the domain must. Now, if this must is not what attained, then it is not what a relation. So it says every element of the domain must have an image in the codomain. But I say every element of, let's say this as an example, we call it here M, we call it what? A, B, C, D. Call this is codomain, let's call it K, call it what? X, Y, Z, Y. Now this is connected. Now connecting this here attention, I'm going to be using this to explain what the relation is. Now this, don't forget, it said that every element of the domain must have an image. So that every element of this domain must have what? An image in K. So this to this, this to this, this to this. Now, if it is what mismatched like this. Mismatched like this, and this is a relation. Why is it a relation? Because it satisfies what the first condition of a relation. That every element of the domain must have an image in the what? In the codomain. So every element in M must have an image in the codomain. Now, going further, they said that the image of every element of the codomain is unique. So the image, that is the image in set K of this of the domain M must be unique. Therefore, when I say unique, I meant that it has to be what? Matched into what? Every what? Element in your domain individually. So if I match my B to my X, if I should match B to X, it is no longer a relation. Why is it not a relation? Because what? The image of element what? A of element A and B is not unique. So the image is not unique. Now when I say it's not unique, because it is matched, both of them are matched to one particular what? Element, or are matched to one what? Image. So by so, it will draw a conclusion that it is not a relation. So look, let's pick up some examples. Now look at this. We have what? This as a function. 1, a function A, 1, 2, 3, B, A, B, C. Now, this is not, it was matched from 1 to A and from 3 to B. Now, this is not a function or a mapping. This is not a function or a mapping. Now, why is it not a function? Well, let me explain. It's not a function, not because of C is not mapped. It's not because of C doesn't have what it corresponded. But it is not a function because 2 was what? Left out. But look at what it says, that every element of the domain. It said every, but now we left 2 out. Because of this 2 we left out, it is not a relation, or it is not a what? A mapping. Because what? 2 of the what? Of the domain, or rather I would say the element 2 of the domain is unmatched. So we didn't match what? The element 2. So now look at the next example here. We have what? 1, 2, 3. Now look at 1 is K is an image of what? 1. L is an image of 3. M is an image of 3, 2 and 3. Now this is not a mapping or a function. It is not a mapping or a function because the element or the image is not unique. 2 here has, M here has what? It's an image to two different what? Elements of the, two different elements of the domain. So M is an image of 2 and 4. And the second condition of a relation said that what the image of every element, the image of every element in the domain is unique. But here, the image of every element here is not unique. So since it's not unique, that is why what this is not a relation. So if it's a relation, for it to be a relation, M has to have just a distinct element in set A or in the domain. Now, still on it, we have what? Types of mapping. Now, the first type of mapping we have here is a what? One-to-one mapping. So now, a one-to-one mapping is a mapping which matches a unique element from the domain to the codomain. Do we get it? Now this is a keyword. It matches a unique word element from what? From the domain to the codomain. Now these four words are the words keywords. They matches for unique element from domain to the codomain. So if I have this A, I have this B, function get this A or B. I have 1, 2, 3, A, B, C. Now this is going to be what? What happens if this matches? Now this is what they want to watch, because what it matches a unique element from the domain to the codomain. So an example of one-to-one mapping is here. We have what a mapping which associates each state in Nigeria to its capital. So, for example, the capital of Lagos cannot be the capital of Kaduna. They are what? Unique. So, that is a perfect example of a one-to-one mapping. So, another example here is a mapping which assigns each principal to their various school. So now, the principal of your school cannot be the principal of another school at the same time. So, the principals, they are unique to a particular school in a particular time. So this is what are two examples of mapping. We have more which you can sit and think about. Now, pay close attention. Now look at this question here. The question here says that let X be a set of real numbers from f of x and s to x. A mapping defines by, now what is the mapping defined by? So the mapping here is defined by what? F of x is equal to 2x plus 5. Okay? So, f of x equals to what? 2x plus 5. So, they say what? Is f a 1-to-1 function? Or is f a 1-1 function? Now, look at this. We have what? The diagram. So, let's match them. So, what is the first function again? What's the first element? That's what? F of minus 2, which is 2 times minus 2 plus 5. That is equal to 2 times minus 4 plus 5. That is equal to 1. So minus 2 is matched. Minus 2 here is matched to your f. Now, let's go further. F of 3. F of 3 is equal to 2 times 3 plus 5. So 2 times 3 here is 6 plus 5. That is going to give us what? 11. So this is what? Matched to 11. So going further here, so your f of what? 5. F of 5 here is 2 times 5 plus 5. 2 times 5 here is 10 plus 5 here is 15, which is matched to this. I will have what? F of 1. F of 1 here is 2 times 1 plus 5. 2 times 1 here is what? 2. 2 plus 5 here is 7. So this is matched to this. Now what is the question asked? So the question asked us, is F a 1-to-1 function? Now, what we define 1-to-1 function as? We define 1-to-1 function as a function that has a distinct matching from what? From the domain to the codomain. Now, if you pay attention here, the matching from domain here to the codomain, or domain here to the codomain, now the matching here is what? Unique. So since the matching here is unique, we can say that what? Now this function, the function is a 1-1 mapping. So we have it as our final answer. So this is also what? A perfect example of a 1-1 mapping. Now, we are moving further. Now, we have what? The onto mapping, which is a type of mapping. Now, onto mapping here is a mapping, please pay attention, if every element of the codomain is an image. If every element of the codomain is an image of at least one element in the domain. Now, so one thing is, your auto mapping sometimes can be a relation. Sometimes your auto mapping can be a one-one mapping, and sometimes your auto mapping might not be a relation. So it says again that if every element of the codomain is an image of at least one image in the domain. So it can be one image, it can be two image, it can be three image in the what? In the domain, but it has to be what? At least one. So every member of the codomain is an image of at least what? One member of the range. So every what member of the codomain is an image of at least one member. I'm going to explain this using what the arrow diagram. This one member of the what? One member of the range of an onto mapping. Okay? So every member of the codomain is an image of at least one member of the range of an onto mapping is equal. So the image of what? An onto mapping is equal to the what? The range of an onto mapping is equal to the codomain. So when we're talking about onto mapping, your range given in what? An onto mapping is equal to your codomain. So the codomain is never greater or lesser or missing anything as the what? The range of that particular function. Now, we have an example here. Which is, let x be the mapping h of function s to y, which is defined below. Then we have the function here, s to y, which is defined below here. We have that e is what, an image of a and b in the domain, f is an image of c, so g is an image of what, d and e, h has an image. Now look at, this is not an onto mapping. This is not an onto mapping. Why is it not an onto mapping? So H cannot be an onto mapping because the what? Image F is not an image of any element in let me write that down. H is not an image. H is not an image of any function of any what element in the domain. Now look at, so because of H is not what a function of any element in X, which is domain, so it made this particular function what? Not to be what? An onto function. Hence, don't forget, because what did they say here? So they made mention of something here. They said that the range of an onto function is equal to the codomain. Now look at, the range of this function now is now what? If I ask you the range of this particular function is now E, F, and G. This is the range. So, but they said in what? In mapping, in what onto mapping, the range is equal to your what? Codomain. The range is equal to the codomain. But look at in this expression, my H is left out. So, therefore, this particular H, the function F, or the mapping H, is not an onto function. So I've told you, give me two conditions. These are two conditions. H is not an image of any element in the domain, and what? The range and the domain are not equal. So these are the two what conditions that make this particular expression not to be an onto function or an onto mapping. Now we have what an example here, which says, which of the following relation is not a function? Now, first and foremost, let's pay attention. I gave us experienced for a what? A relation. Like it was criteria for a relation to be a function. So let's go back to it and check which of the following ones does not meet that relation. Now, A, or rather, I is not a function because the image has two, the image here has what? Has two elements in the domain. So I is not a what? A function. No? Okay, look at I. It has what? One element in the domain has what? Two images. One element in the domain has what? Two images. Now going further, what about the third? So paying attention to your I. Every element in the domain has a unique element. That's a unique element in your codomain. So this is a relation. This is a relation. Now look at this. It has your I. It has element here, D, okay. But now look at your Y, or an element here, has double image in the what codomain. So this is not a relation. So II is not a relation. So the question here says which of the following is what not a relation? So you have what C, which is what I and II only. It's not what? A relation or a function. Going further, we have another example here which says let x be -3, 3, and let y be 1 and 10. Now the diagram shown below illustrates the mapping from set x to what? Set y. Now this is the diagram. Now they ask us what? Determine the rule of the mapping. Determine the rule of the mapping. Now for us to determine the rule of the mapping, it simply means what is the mathematical relation? What is the mathematical relation that if you input is going to give us what? This as a value. Now, pay close attention. Now, how do we get 3 from 3 and from 3 to give us the value called what? 10 here. So let's see. We can say x squared plus 1. So here, if I have -3 squared plus 1, that's going to give -3 squared is going to give me 9 plus 1, and 9 plus 1 is 10. Okay. Now 0 squared plus 1, that's going to give me 1. Now what about 3 squared plus 1, that's going to give me 9 plus 1, that is equal to 10. Therefore, the what? The rule of the mapping. The rule of the mapping is x squared plus 1. Now, aside from that, they want for you to ask, is the mapping 1 to 1? No. Is the mapping 1 to 1? No. Why is it not 1 to 1? The mapping is not 1 to 1 because it has what? The image has two distinct what? Elements in the domain. Because of the two distinct elements in X, which is our what? Domain, that makes this particular function not to be what? 1-to-1. So is the function 1-to-1? Is this 1-to-1 or 1-1 function? No, it is not 1-1 function. Now, going further, they ask, is the function onto? Is the function an onto function? Yes, it is an onto function. Yes, it is an onto function. Now, why is it an onto function, or how do we explain this? It's an onto function because every element in the codomain is matched to at least one element. Now, every element in the codomain here is at least an image of what? At least one element in the what? In the domain. So, no element in your codomain, your codomain is left out. Everything was what? Explored. So it's at least one what? It's at least what? One element in the domain. So that is why it is what? It is an onto function. Last they ask, what is the range of the mapping? I explained to us what the range of the mapping is. Now the range of the mapping is, that is what? Elements of the range of a matrix, sorry, the range of a function is the element that has a corresponding value or corresponding what? Image of, or is an image of what? The domain. So here, one here has a corresponding value. 10 here has what? Two corresponding values. So the range of this particular mapping here is what? 1,10. Special mapping. Now, we have here that what? Let F be a function of F of A of S to S is a mapping defined by F of S is equal to X. Now, what does this mean? First and foremost, this means that what S exists in X. Then they say what? F here is an identity matrix. Well, what is the identity matrix? It's an identity matrix because it's an identity mapping rather because it takes an element onto itself. This, it takes an element onto itself. Now, since they said that what? F of X here is equal to S. Now, you can call this also what? An identity mapping. But this is what? You can call it what? Your special mapping. It's then you call it what? Identity mapping. Or special mapping. Now, in our of this. Now, it takes what an element onto itself. If I say f of one is 1, f of 2 here is 2. So this is what a special what or an identity mapping. F of here gave me what? F of B here gave me B, F of C here gave me C. Now, a special mapping, this is what? A special mapping, I like us to note, pay attention, that's what? A special mapping is a 1-to-1 and also an onto function. Why is it a 1-to-1? It's a 1-to-1 because every element here is matched to a unique element here. And it's an onto function because your range is equal to what? Your codomain. So what I'd like us to note that your special mappings or your identity mapping is a 1-to-1 function and also an onto function at the same time. We have a constant mapping. So a constant mapping, this is a kind of mapping that directs every element in the domain to a particular element in the codomain. So it directs what every element in the domain to one particular element in the codomain. So we have what the arrow diagram here. So every element in this what in our domain here was what channels directly to the co-domain. So this is either, this is not what a relation, not the relation. So this is what it looks like, pay close attention. Now, composite function here. So the composite function or composite mapping has to do with what? Two different mappings, right? Now, such that what the codomain of F. Now this is a codomain of F. Let me bring another mapping. Now this here is a codomain of F, right? Now the codomain of F is the domain of another function G. Now look at this codomain here. Is the what domain of what? Another fourth function. Now look at this. We say what? The mapping F of G, that is what? F of G is also known as a composite what? Function. So it can also be what? Written as what? Fg. That is what? A function of G. Now pronounced as what? F of G. Now let's take examples, other composite functions. Now look at this question on composite function, which is a jam question. So the question here says that what? That G of X is equal to 2X plus 3. And then what? F of X is equal to 3X squared minus 2X plus 4. So they ask us to find F of G of what? Minus 3. Now, first of all, we want to start from the inside, which is what? G of what? Minus 3. So putting what? Minus 3 into this place, it becomes 2 times what? Minus 3 plus, that is equal to minus 6 plus 3, that is equal to minus 3. So having gotten this, then this becomes, taking your what? Answer, put into this place, that is what? Your G of minus 3 given, that's what? F of minus 3. So F of minus 3 here is equal, so put it into the F, that's 3 times what? Minus 3 squared, minus 2 times minus 3, plus 4. 3 squared is what? 9. 3 times 9, that's what? 27 minus times minus plus what? Plus 6 plus 4. That is equal to 27 plus 3, that is what? 33. Then 3 plus, that is equal to 37. So we'll have 37 here as our what? We'll have 37 here as our final answer, which is what? A. Now, we have another example here, which is what? G of y is equal to this, then we'll find g of y plus 3. So g of y plus 3 becomes the solution here says your g of y plus 3 here is equal to, and here you see y, replace it with what? Y plus 3. So y plus 3 minus 3 over 11 plus 11 over y plus 3 squared minus 9. So at this junction, this is not equal to what? Y over 11 plus 11 over, now look at this, x squared minus what? 3 squared. This is what they call difference of 2 squared. If you cannot, you can spell that x minus 3, x plus 3. So this is going to be my x, this is my 9. So this becomes what? This becomes y plus 3 plus what? 3. And what? Y plus 3 minus 3. Now, this particular expression here is a difference of 2 squared of this expression. Don't forget that this line here was what? Broken down to be expressed as what? 3 raised to our what? 2. Now, explain that 3 raised to power 2. That was how, now look at this expression. It's now what? Y plus 3 squared minus what? 3 raised to power 2. So this is difference of 2 squared. So the difference of 2 squared becomes, if you have x squared minus y squared, this is now what? X plus y, x minus y. So I will treat this, these two like this. This becomes x plus what? 3 plus 3. Then what? X plus 3 minus 3. So at this junction, it becomes y over 11 plus 11 over y plus 3 plus 3, 6 times y. 3 minus 3, 0. So at this junction, you have this as your final answer to the jam question. So this is what? Very, very easy. So we're going to pick more examples and work on them. Now, if you pay close attention to this question, we have a one question here that says that, given that solution, given that what? F of what? F of x is equal to 1 minus 2x, and g of x is equal to 2x plus 1. So, here you ask us to look for what? F of what? F of what? Gx. F of g of x. That is, put g of x into f of x. What is f of x? 1 minus 2. Whenever you have x in f of x, put what? G of x. So what is g of x? 2x plus 1. This is now 1 minus 2 times that minus 4x minus 2. So this is equal to minus 4x, 1 minus 2, minus 1. So this is my what? F of what? F of g of x. Now let us know what is what? G of what? F of x. What is g of f of x? So please take your, what is my g of x? My g of x is what? 2 over, well, anyway, I see x in g, replace this with what? F of x. What is f of x? 1 minus what? 2x. 1 minus 2x plus. So instead of writing x here, I wrote this in place of x plus what? Plus 1. So this is now equal to 2 minus 4x plus 1. That is equal to 3 minus 4x. So that's not the final answer. The question said, find what? This. So this becomes f of g of x minus g of f of x. So f of g of x gave us minus 4x minus 1. Minus open bracket. G of x gave us 3 minus what? 4x. So at this juncture, you can now say what? Minus 4x minus 1. Minus 3. That is minus 3. That is plus 4x. So 4x plus 4x comes to my floor. I'm left with what? Minus 1 minus 3. That's equal to minus 4. So I mean that's minus 4. So we have what? Our final answer here as B, which is what? Minus 4. Final answer. Now, inverse of a function, this is easy. Now, if y is equal to f of x is a function, if y is equal to f of x is a function, then we obtain the inverse function, which is denoted by f raised to the minus 1, by solving the equation y is equal to f of x for. Now, look at this. We have the equation y is equal to f of x. Now, listen to me. It is very, very easy. Simply, what I to do for the inverse, make this guy, which is your S here, solve the formula. You make this your solve the formula. After making your solve the formula, when you get your final answer, you interchange your value of x to y. You change your x to y and your what? Your y to x. So when you interchange this, then you'll be able to what, find what inverse of a mapping. Now I'm going to take what an example and show you the whole interchanging and how easy it is. So it's very, very straightforward and its approach is easy. Let's take up what an example. Now, look at this question. A question of what? Inverse of a matrix, of a mapping, rather. So here it says, a function f is defined on R. The set of three numbers by f is to x, which is equal to what? X plus 3 over what? X minus 2. Here, x is not equal to 2. Find what? The inverse. Now, looking for the inverse here, I can rearrange that what? F of x here is equal to what? X plus 3 over x minus 2. So, in that shape, let's say, let y be equal to f of x. So, y is equal to x plus 3 of over x minus. So, at this junction, cross multiply. So, this becomes x minus 2. Y times x minus 2 is equal to what? X plus 3. This times this, that is what? Xy minus, this times this, minus 2y is equal to x plus 3. So now what do you do? Make x subject formula. Making x subject of formula, now this becomes what? So you have to bring all x to one side. That becomes xy minus x is equal to 3 plus 2y. So this is your factor your s out. That's s open bracket y minus 1 is equal to 3 point plus what? 2y. So at this junction, divide both sides by y minus 1. So this cancels. So s here is equal to 3 plus 2y over y minus 1. Now look at this. Don't forget that you made an assumption. You made an assumption. What is the assumption? It said that y equals this. So you have to remove y from this expression and take it back. So at this junction, you have to interchange. So this here is going to be your f of x. It's equal to that 3 plus anywhere you see y, you replace it with what? X plus 2x over what? S minus 1. And this is your final answer. Please, I wouldn't like you to see this particular edge is confusing. What do you do? This is F inverse, please. This is F inverse. And what you do after making F cellular formula, so let's replace it clearly. Replace it easily with your what? With your this. Now, after replacing it, so here you have y, you have to take what your x back to that place because what the particular expression is in terms of what? X. So that's how we got what? This as our inverse. Now look at this. The inverse of a function. Inverse of a function, what? F is given by this. Now, they say what? Now look at this question. This question, we only have our evaluation in inverse. F inverse of S is equal to S plus 1 over 4. Now, at this junction, since we are reversing this, I want to what? Bring in what the value that's supposed to be here. This becomes what y here is equal to x plus 1 over 4. So at this juncture, you have to reverse the statement back to what here it's supposed to be. So reversing the data, they're going to correspond because that's x plus 1 is equal to 4y. So at this juncture, x here is equal to 4y minus 1. Having format as well. Now, you cannot say this is your final answer because you're asked to what? Take back the function in what? Terms of what? S. So this becomes what? F of S down here is not equals to 4 instead of Y. Please do not write the answer in Y because Y is the number variable. As 4X minus 1. So having your answer as 4X minus 1, which that is your final answer. Now we have a question. So the question here says, state the condition necessary for a function to have a mass. Right. So number one, for a function to have inverse, the two condition must be satisfied. The two condition must be satisfied. What? It must be a 1-to-1 packet. It must be an onto mapping. So these two conditions must be satisfied before the inverse of a particular function can be what? Okay. Now, going further, what you said in B, it said f of x is equal to 4x minus 3 over 2x plus 1. And it said what? And g of x is equal to 1 plus 4x over 2x plus 1. So here, we are asked to find what? Inverse of s, f inverse of. So we're looking for inverse. So how do we get our inverse here? So f of s here, that's y is equal to what? 4x minus 3 over 2x plus 1. So at this juncture, you cross multiply. At this juncture, you cross multiply. That becomes 2xy plus y is equal to 4x minus 3. So bring everything with what? X one side, so factorize as 2xy minus 4x is equal to minus 3 minus y. So bring out my x out, that's x open bracket 2y minus 4 is equal to minus 3 minus y. So divide both sides by 2y minus 4. 2y minus 4. So 2y minus 4 cancel 2y minus 4. So if you cancels out, okay, if you cancels out, we'll be left with that x is equal to minus 3 minus y over 2y minus 4. So conclusively, so yeah, f inverse of s is equal to minus 3 minus y over 2y minus 4. So, going further, the question asks us to find what are we to find? It asks us to find g inverse. So, g inverse of x here is equal to, okay, we don't do this, so what's g of x first? So g of x here is equal to 1 plus 4x. Okay, please, before you proceed, you can't leave your final answer like this, please. Because this is in terms of y. So this becomes what? F of s, is everywhere I see y, you've made it to the s, that's minus 3 minus x over 2x minus 4. This is your final answer. please, you cannot give your answer in terms of words, because this one is a dummy variable. You can't give your answer in this term. You have to be in terms of x, which is the particular thing the question came with. So now, so g of x here is equal to 1 plus 4x over what? 2x plus 1. So let's say this is it. So let's what? Let g of x be equal to h. So h here is equal to 1 plus 4x over 2x plus 1. So at this junction, cross multiply. Now you come 2x h plus h is equal to 1 plus 4x. So bringing them down to x one side, that's 2x h minus 4x is equal to 1 minus h. If I'm correct, the x is equal to 2h minus 4 is equal to 1 minus h. So dividing both sides by 2h minus 4, 2h minus 4. So if you divide both sides, the x here now will be equal to 1 minus h over 2h minus 4. So I cannot even answer in terms of h. What we are asked to find is what? G of. So g inverse of x is equal to 1 minus s. So instead of writing your h now, you can bring back your s. 1 minus s, 2x minus 4. And that is what you have here as what? The final answer for what? For g inverse of s. Now let's go forward. Moving forward, question said, so moving forward, it said, find I, it said what? Which is what? F inverse of G inverse of 0. So what is my G inverse? G inverse of x is equal to g inverse of s, so I've wiped it. Let's get it back. So going further here, so if this is my g inverse of s, then what is my g inverse of 0? My g inverse of 0 becomes 1 minus 0 over 2 times 0 minus 4. That is 1 over minus 4. That becomes minus 1 over 4. So Putting this into my what? F. Because g of what? G inverse of 0 gave me what? Minus 1 over 4. So I'm going to take this minus 1 over 4 and put it into my what? F. And what is f? F is equal to, okay, let's see, f inverse of g inverse of 0 is equal to minus 3, anyway you see x, you replace it with minus 1 over 4, minus 1 over 4, over 2 times minus 1 over 4, minus what? 4. This is equal to minus 3 minus minus is plus 1 over 4, divided by 2 here 1, 2 here 2, that's minus 1 over 2, minus 4. So I can say, looking for my LCM, so what is my LCM? LCM here is what? 4. 4 divided by 1, 4. 4 times minus 3, that's minus 12 plus 4 divided by 4, 1. 1 times 4 divided by, my LCM here is what? 2. 2 divided by 2, 1. 1 times minus 1, minus 1. Minus 2 divided by, 2 divided by, 1. That is what? 2. 2 times minus 4, that's what? Minus 8. That's now where our solution finishes. And this is now equal to minus 11 over 4 divided by minus 9 over 2. Now, paying close attention to this. So, sign. If I can change my division sign to multiplication, that is equal to minus 11 over 4 times 2 over 9. So minus cancel minus. So what are we left with here? 2 here, 1, 2 here, 2. So what are we left with here? That's what? 11 over 2 times 9. This is equal to 11 over 2 times 9 here is 18. So we have our final answer here as 11 over 18. So here, we're having our examples, our exercise, I mean. Here we are what? Explain the following terms, draw an arrow diagram representing them, the codomain, domain range, image. Then you have the next question, which is number 2. We ask you to what? Find g of f of x. Then number 3, give example of a relation, a one-to-one function, or mapping, onto mapping, and an identity mapping.